Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Viterbi Decoder. Viterbi Decoder is used for convolutional decoding. The Viterbi algorithm is a maximum likelihood decoder that determines the path that W most likely corresponds to. To achieve maximum likelihood decoding, each branch in the trellis is assigned a metric, which is the Hamming distance between the received pair of bits and the ideal pair, that is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1, for hard decision decoding. Therefore, a branch metric can take values of 0, 1, and 2 in case of 2, 1, 2 or 2-bit decoder. For soft decision decoding, Euclidean distance is used, which we are not going to discuss over here. Each path in the trellis is also assigned a metric, that is sum of the branch metrics forming the path. Each time we receive a pair of channel symbols, we are going to compute a metric to measure the distance between what we received and all of the possible channel symbol pairs we could have received. There are only two possible channel symbol pairs we could have received initially, that is 00 and 11. That is because we know the convolutional encoder was initialized to the all zeros state, and given one input bit is equal to 1 or 0, there are only two states which could transition to, and two possible outputs of the encoder. These possible outputs of the encoder are 00 and 11. Now suppose the transmitted 2, 1, 2 in convolutional code is V is equal to 11101000001 and 11. Incurs 2-bit errors at two locations, at this location and this location, so that the W is equal to V plus E is equal to 11101000011 and 11. Now how this decoder works? As we know that initial state of the at the time of encoding, the initial state of the M1 and M2, that is the shift registers, is always 00. So the input bit can be either 1 or 0 because K is equal to 1 in this case. So the output can be either 00 or 11. There are only two possibilities. So we will start from 00. Now as we can see over here that we have received 11. In that case, there are only two possibilities. Either this 11 is received correctly or incorrectly. If it is received correctly, then the output is 11. In that case, the metric is 0 because the Hamming distance between 11, this 11, and this 11 is 0. Or you can say this 11 and this 11 is 0. But the Hamming distance between this 11 and this 00 is 2. That is in case it is received incorrectly. Now, as we know that there are only two possibilities of the outcome in case of when the initial state is 00, that is either it is 00 and 11. But the possibility of receiving incorrect bits or correct bits are 4, either it is 01, 10, 00 or 11. So if suppose this had been changed, the error had occurred in this bit over here, then the branch metric would have been 1 and 1 over here. It means the probability or likelihood would have been equal in that case. So we would have to continue in both the directions. But in this case, as we can see, the metric over here is 0 and here it is 2. So it is most likely this one is the right path and this is the wrong path, or this is the wrong branch. So since the likelihood is much more in this case compared to this one, so we will continue following that this path and will discontinue this one. So we continue decoding using this transition state. We do not try to find the path on at this state. Why? Because the metric is branch metric is true, this 2, and it is very unlikely that this is the 2 bits have 2-bit error has occurred. So assuming that this 1-bit error has no error has occurred and the branch metric is 0, in that case the next 2 bits we receive are 1 and 0. When we are at 10 and we receive 10, then there are two possibilities. Again, here in this case, if it is received correctly, then the branch metric is 0 and the next state is 1 1, and if it is received incorrectly, then the branch metric is 2. That is in case it was 0 1 instead of 1 0. Again, what we'll do, that we'll discontinue, we'll not continue from this state furthermore, and we'll continue from this state because the branch metric is 0. Now at this 1 1, as you can see that here it is not clear cut. Why? Because the error has occurred over here. As we can see, this error has occurred, which is written in red over here. So because of error, the branch matrix which we calculate here is 1 1. So it is, the likelihood is equal when both, it might have been 1 1 or it might not have been 1 1. It would have been instead of 1 1, it could have been 1 0 or 0 1. Both, the likelihood is equal for both. So in that case, what we'll do, that we'll continue decoding. At this stage, the decoder cannot make the decision, so it will just put it into its memory and will keep decoding using both the nodes. So that this next 00 is decoded for both the nodes, that this state and this state, because here the branch metric is 1. So it's quite possible that this was received as the next state could have been from this point onwards, and could have it is also possible that it is from this point onwards. So now when we calculate from this one, we find that there the branch metric is 2 in case if it is was 00. So 00 and 1 1, they are compared, and it is 00, and in this case this could have been 1. But in this case, as you can see, if it is 00, the 00 is compared with this 00, it is 0, and if it is compared with this 1 1, it is 2. So we assume that the most likely the path is in this direction, and we discontinue further decoding in at this node and this node, and we continue at this node. Now when we receive 1 1, then this 1 1 is compared at this node with 0 1 and 1 0. Again, the likelihood is equal, 1 and 1. So we need to decode at both the, we are the next two ones are compared at both the nodes, this one and this one. But as you can see that when we compare it with this one, the least branch matrix is this 0 compared to this 2 and 1 and 1 over here. So if we calculate the total branch matrices, that is 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 1. So the total is 2 only. But if we follow any other path, we can immediately see that at this stage initially it is 2. So it is not possible that it could have gone below value of 2. It must have been greater than 2. So it is not likelihood that it could have been continued from this state. So this is rejected. Similarly, here it is 2. Again, we can easily see that it is discontinued because it is that the initial stage it is 2, and it's the same philosophy is here and here and at all the branches. So the maximum likelihood path which we can, the least metric path which we can calculate is 2, and if we follow this path, which is this one, this which is shown over here with purple line, violet line, this one is the most likelihood, most likely the path of the decoding. So if we follow this path, we immediately can decode the correct output, because here, as we can see, that when we are here and if this path is followed, that we know that it should be 1 0. So this 1 1 is correctly decoded as 10 instead of 11. Although it was received as 11, but decoder has decoded as it as 10 instead of 11. Similarly, here you can see the receive bit is 11, but as we know that it goes this way, if it goes this way, then it knows that the output is 01. So again, the decoder has decoded as 01 instead of 11. So it does not detect the error, but it since it decodes using the most likelihood path, so it because of that most likelihood, it can decode the correct bits, and then this one is 11. So as we can see, although we received the code word with errors, two errors, the decoder decoded it correctly. Recursive system convolutional code. This is a half-rate recursive systematic convolutional encoder with constraint length 4. Recursive systematic convolutional code produces systematic convolutional codes. But in the convolutional codes which we have seen before, they are not systematic, they are non-systematic. What is the advantage of systematic convolutional codes? An important property of codes is that they are non-catastrophic. We have seen that we don't want catastrophic codes because they generate multiple errors. So we want non-catastrophic codes. So if we want to generate non-catastrophic codes, then in that case we should prefer this using this recursive systematic convolutional code.